Have you ever wondered why your period blood isn't always the same? Sometimes it is bright red, other times it is brown, pink, orange, and even black. And some other times it could just present with a watery period blood. But what does these color changes actually mean for your health? So today we're discussing both the texture and colors of your period blood. You get to find out what is normal and what is not, and when these different color changes could be sending an urgent warning to you. In my previous video on this topic, we were able to reach out to thousands of women in the United States, United Kingdom, and almost every part of the globe, and they had so many questions. So today we are presenting an updated version of this video with latest medical insight on textures and flow. By the end of this video, I'm going to be answering some of the most frequently asked questions in the comment section of the previous video. Therefore, by the end of this video, you're going to think differently about the different color changes of your period blood. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Good Life Medis on YouTube, where we discuss everything reproductive health and women's wellness, from periods down to pregnancy. Please, if this is why you're here, like this video, hit on that subscribe button, turn on the bell so that you don't get to miss out on any of our weekly uploads. Let's get started. Now, let's start with pinkish color of period blood. This often surprises most women when your flow is just light pink. Pinkish color of period blood happens when your blood mixes with cervical fluid as well as with vaginal discharge, making it look like it is diluted. And this is mostly common at the beginning of your period or towards the ending days of your period when it is still starting or is already slowing down. Light pink color of period blood does not necessarily mean your estrogen levels is low, because it could happen whether or not it is normal, low, or high. But here is where you should be cautious. If you're pregnant and experiences pink spotting, if it is not implantation bleeding, then it could be something serious. Any form of bleeding you experience when you're pregnant is a medical emergency, and you should be speaking with your doctor already. Or if this happens towards the middle of your cycle, it could be an ovulation spotting, or it could be a sign of perimenopause depending on your age. Most probably, if you're already in your 40s and beyond, it could be indicating perimenopausal symptoms. Therefore, if you experience pinkish blood consistently, it is best you run a day 2 hormone profile test to know if there's anything that is going on with your hormones. But if it is just that you experience this towards the start of your period or towards the ending days of your period, then this is completely fine. Next, let's talk about the most familiar color, bright red. But is it always a good sign? Bright red period blood indicates fresh blood flowing steadily from your uterus. This is very common in a healthy menstrual cycle. However, gynecologists warn that heavy bright red menstrual bleeding, especially accompanied with heavy clots, requiring you to change your pads or your tampon very often or very regularly, might signal an underlying health condition like a uterine fibroid, polyps, or even as a result of miscarriage, that is if you are already pregnant, or even as a result of bleeding from an ectopic pregnancy. An ectopic pregnancy is any pregnancy that is not developing right inside of your uterus. Sometimes it could be developing in your ovaries, or most often developing in either of your fallopian tubes. That is why I always advocate you start your prenatal appointment immediately you find out that you're pregnant, so that if peradventure this pregnancy is not developing at the right place, it will be found out on time. Therefore, bright red period blood is usually normal, but pay attention to the amount of flow and whether or not it is accompanied with severe lower abdominal pain, because menstrual period is not supposed to be so painful. That is another issue on its own. I've discussed about the causes of very severe menstrual cramps in one of my videos. If you would like to know some of the causes, you can check out that video. It will be in the description box. Now, let's talk about when your period is darker, a brown color. A brown period blood simply means older blood that is taking longer to leave your uterus and got the chance to be oxidized into a darker color. And this is typically more common towards the ending days of your period. Or also, you can notice this when you're just waking up from sleep after a long hours of rest. This is equally common at the beginning of your period. So many women panic when they see a brown period blood, but this is completely normal. This is when you should be worried. When you see brown discharge or brown period blood at mid-cycle or after sex. Outside that, a brown period blood is considered an old blood, and this is completely normal. Another is black color of period blood. This might look alarming, especially if you haven't seen this before. But what does it really mean? It usually looks jelly-like in appearance, but it is actually old blood that has been in the reproductive tract that got clotted into a jaw-like. Or this could be the lining of your uterus that came out in chunk. If you're able to smear it against your finger, you will be able to see the hidden redness in it, indicating that this blood isn't actually black, but it was previously red. It's just that it got oxidized into this black color. Don't worry, you can actually look at your period blood, you can actually touch it to feel it. It's not dirty, it came out of you, it is your blood. Black period blood usually happens when the flow rate is slow and light. It is not as a result of blockage. Normally, black period blood is not supposed to be a cause of concern unless it is accompanied with foul smell, fever, large clots, or severe lower abdominal pain. Then it could be a pointer to an infection, return products of conception, or even to something more serious. I have a detailed video on this channel where I talked about period blood clots. Yes, it is normal in some cases, but there's a particular size you will see and is no longer normal. So if you usually experience period blood clots, you might want to see that video to see what is normal and what is not. The link will be in the description box. So always consult your healthcare provider if you experience black period blood with these symptoms I mentioned earlier. Some women think black period blood could be coming from your last month's menstrual period, but no, it's not. Remember, your vagina is continually being cleansed with cervical fluids and vaginal discharge that makes that area clean. So there's no way there are going to be period from your last month's menstrual period and it's just waiting for your next period to surface. So that is not what it is. Black period blood is normal unless it's accompanied with foul smell, fever, low abdominal pains, or some other concerning symptoms. Let's proceed. Number 5 is orange color of period blood. Now, here is the part that surprises most women. Can your period blood be orange? Should you be worried? Now, if it is not because your period blood is combining with your cervical fluid or that your period is particularly lighter that particular month, then gynecologists warn that orange color of period blood that can also be described as rust color of period blood is simply due to a sexually transmitted infection, especially if it comes with a strong odor or is accompanied by itch. Finally, gray color of period blood. This is usually rare and concerning. It is more like a vaginal discharge than a period blood. So your period blood cannot be gray. It is a vaginal discharge and it is associated with infection. In the US, the CDC categorizes a grayish color of vaginal discharge to be linked with bacterial vaginosis, especially when it is accompanied with fishy odor. If you're pregnant and experiences a grayish color of vaginal discharge, this is a reason to call your doctor and seek medical attention, because grayish form of vaginal discharge, especially accompanied with fishy smell or fishy odor, is a symptom of bacterial vaginosis and it is not any form of period blood. So let's now look at the frequently asked questions about this period blood, because this is a huge topic on its own. It attracts a whole lot of questions. So the first question is, can what you eat affect the color of your period blood? Yes, what you eat can affect your period blood, not just the color, even whether or not you're going to be experiencing so much painful cramps that month. What you eat has direct impact on your period, especially processed sugars. When you also have an underlying medical condition such as anemia or even dehydration, it can equally affect your period blood. Another question is, I am discovering brownish blood or blackish blood. Is it normal? From everything said here in this video, if you paid attention, you will agree with me that it is normal unless it is accompanied by other symptoms that I have already stated earlier. So conclude, your period can be a powerful health signal, from harmless changes to powerful red flags that you should never ignore. Remember, every woman's cycle is different, but persistent unusual colors, heavy bleeding, severely painful menstrual cramps are reasons to speak with your doctor, irrespective of where you might be, whether in the US, in the UK, in Canada, Africa, France, wherever you might be. The science is clear everywhere, okay? And that will be all for today. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. Click on the subscribe to join this family. Also, turn on the bell so that you never miss any of our uploads. Feel free to equally share this video to anyone who you think you might need it. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you for watching.